Go. Oh, hey, Dan.
Oh, hey, Ryan.
Don't call me Ryan. In for honor, my name is Carl Soderberg. I am a Viking from Gotland.
You know, I've got an array of questions for you. First and foremost, Soderberg, isn't that some director?
Steven Soderberg. You should know, Mr. Hollywood.
Mr. Hollywood? You're more Hollywood than I am.
You lived in Los Angeles for 24 weeks.
Excuse me, it was actually 74 days plus 71 days. but you go to L.A. every other month for all these big fancy meetings.
I have been to L.A. once in my whole life.
That is untrue.
That is not untrue. Anyway, we're playing 2v2s in For Honor.
How do you feel about that?
I feel like this is going to be really fun because I'm playing the game anyway, and I need content for while we're away at PAX.
All right. Well, I'm fired up because we've been on a little hiatus. We kind of put the Hearthstone on the back burner permanently.
Yeah, but this is like Hearthstone, but instead of cards, we're using shards, you know?
What do you mean by shards?
You know, like we got sharp sticks. They call them swords in this day and age.
If you were...
How much For Honor have you played since the Tournament of Shame?
Just precisely as much as I needed to.
So zero, I suppose.
Wait, my question for you, you're not going to get out of this one. If you're in prison, would you make a custom shard?
You mean like a shank?
Yeah.
I mean, I suppose I would have to, right?
Not necessarily.
Wait, Daniel! I've got him! I don't need this!
But we're trying to win... What? We're trying to win by any means necessary.
Yeah, but now you've given them a license. Oh my god, I am actually bad. You've given them a license to break the code of honor, man.
You know, we've got to get this code of honor on the table now and decide on what side of the coin we lie on. There's a lot of controversy in Kotaku and Polygon. What does For Honor mean?
Well, the game is called For Honor, not With Honor.
So, that means which side of the coin do you stand on?
I stand on the side of the coin that... I stand on the side of the coin that that's not okay, buddy. Look at you, just got his... He's got revenge now as a result of your actions.
Yeah, but he's also banged up.
Yeah, he's got infinity fucking damage now. Dan.
Did you die?
No, but I'm probably gonna.
But I need you.
I am dead. Dan!
What?
Let us do 1v1s, dude. You're throwing chaos into an element that doesn't need to be chaotic.
You never told me how we're going to play this thing. As straight shooters, or are we going to catch hangers on the bottom, Sarge?
I don't know what that means. I've been trying to talk to you. I don't know what that means.
You don't know what cut a hanger, Sarge?
What does that mean? Cut a hanger. Yeah, see? That's called ganking. None of that, please, Dan.
How do I talk back to these people?
You hit T and then tab.
T and then tab. All right.
Respect.
I caught a hanger, Sarge, is from pay that man.
It's from Rounders.
Yes. And remember, he catches a hanger when he catches Edward Norton's hand in the police hall.
I don't know what that. Wait, Ed Norton's in Rounders?
Yeah. He's the worm.
What does that mean?
That's his name,
Dan,
the worm.
How do you talk to people that aren't me? Because even I have been having some trouble, you know? I'm in, like, the Skype conversation. I'm like, where are we going to be, on Discord or on Skype? And you're just like, hit me up on the OG. I don't know what that means.
Okay.
I'm supposed to call you on, like, an analog telephone or something like that?
Well, let's just break it down. So OG, so the new stuff we use is Discord, right? We're in a room called Ultralight Beams, correct?
Of course.
Okay. So the OG would refer to what we used prior to Discord.
Which no, it would refer to the thing that we used first, which is, you know...
It's not ICQ.
We just communicate using, you know, grunts and body language.
You really didn't know what I meant when I said use the OG?
No, I had no idea what you meant.
Sometimes I do have to admit in our Skype conversation, you know how, like, I'll just pop in, drop a sentence, and then leave for, like, 24 hours?
Yeah, no, I'm aware.
I often wonder what people really think, because more often than not, no one responds, but I also...
Right, yeah.
Like, do you look at it and just be like, eh, that's just Dan being Dan, or eh, there's something wrong with him?
It depends on what it is. If it's a particularly good vine, then I'm like, this guy's got his head screwed on straight. But sometimes you're like, you know, you drop a vine and it's just a dude. I don't even get it. Like, it's just a dude going like, and then you're like, everything you link, I can't trust you. Because I go, is this worth watching? And you go, 10 out of 10. I promise. This one's a real 10. Just I timestamped it for you. And then I watch it. And I'm like, that's like a 4.
But it's a 4 that wasn't in your life prior.
Yeah, but the average is a 5, though. If you just go to YouTube and hit like random video. Oh, no. We got the same guy. He knows you're a ganker, Dan. Your reputation precedes you.
So, okay, so let's talk strat for a second.
Yeah.
So we're not going to win by any means necessary?
You're actually making it harder to win when you gank, in my opinion. Well, because if the person knows how to block, like, multi-directionally, you're just filling up their revenge meter like crazy, and they turn into, like, a... You ever see, like, Batman and Robin where Bane's got, like, the toxic green juice pumping through his veins?
Batman and Robin.
You know, the 1998 Joel Schumacher Batman and Robin with George Clooney?
Bane wasn't in that.
He's totally in it.
No, you're thinking of Mr. Freeze.
What the fuck? What? This dude just did a backflip. I've never seen that before in my adult life.
He also has a spiked helmet.
Yeah, no, he's Sonic the Hedgehog. I'm in a fucking world of pain, dude.
Why are we playing all these lifers?
Dude, I'm telling you, the For Honor community has left you behind. Like, people are really, really good now.
Well, shouldn't there be, like, a mechanism for that?
Oh, you're talking about some kind of, like, matchmaking system.
Yeah.
He's done it. He's done it. Dude, Daniel, this guy is full HP.
I was just distracting him. This guy is probably the best For Honor player I've ever played in my life. He's PETA from
the Hunger Games?
Yes.
Is he better than Mathis?
Mathis is like styrofoam.
What does that mean?
It means that you can use it, you get a lot of usage out of it, when it comes time to throw it away, it's just not going to happen.
Do you get a lot of usage out of start? See? Look at, he's doing backflips, dude. This is hell. Basically, like, For Honor has become like Rocket League, where I was really good at it for like a week until people started to get their shit together. And now it's actually hell. Like, now people have gotten so fucking good.
I told you, isn't that PETA and incredible?
This guy is actually, he's doing pretty well. I can't deny that.
I think this fantastic furry guy, I think I can take him out.
You think so?
If you do your part, I'll do my part.
Yeah, I did about 2 damage to this guy.
Are you dead?
Yeah, I am dead.
Drop that res. Drop that G-Hill res. I'll get you.
I don't know what that means.
Hit the button. Hit the button.
No, you don't hit the button. You can fight. Daniel! You got this guy, dude. Yeah, okay. Well,
I feel like I could beat him. If someone else carried their weight, I feel like I could beat him.
Excuse me? You think you can stop that guy? He's fully armored and he's doing backflips. He's presenting his his anus. He's in the lordosis round position.
3. What is lordosis?
It's like when an animal is ready to mate. It puts its butt in the air.
What is lordosis?
You know, Lord, the singer. She invented it.
I thought you were going to say, I thought you just mispronounced Lord Disick.
What is Lord Disick?
You don't know who Lord Disick is?
Is that your Star Citizen name?
No! Lord Disick? I feel like you would love him.
Dude, we got bad at For Honor. What happened? Oh, Jesus. I told you he's Mathis. What do you think?
You guys...
Again on these guys or...
No,
or
you guys... Oh, I can't type them in a message. You guys... Heck.
No!
So Lord Disick is the former husband, not even husband, the baby daddy of Kourtney Kardashian's kids.
The baby daddy of Kourtney Kardashian's kids.
Yes. And his name is Scott Disick, but he refers to himself
as... His name is Scontus?
Scott Disick. But he refers to himself as Lord Disick.
I have to question the human race sometimes. Because, what? I mean, the dude must be really cool. Because if somebody was uncool and they were like, call me Lord Disick, you would be like, all right, Lord Disick, I pledge my fealty to the flag, right? But this guy managed to get, like, I mean, he got a catch to carry his seed.
That's very
despite true. Having a ridiculous moniker.
But what also, before I tell you the one thing I know about Lord Disick, what are you saying about Richard Lord British Garriott by...
Well, I mean, again, he can back it up, right?
Can he, though?
I mean, he's been to space or something. He's been at least into orbit. It's further than any of us have gone.
That's true, but...
Plus, he invented Ultima Online.
That's the only saving grace. If you didn't say that, I was going to give you some... Are you Prestige?
I'm Prestige 1, yeah.
Oh, I know what someone's been doing.
Prestige 1 is, like, below average.
Oh, Dan,
so if I fight someone who's Prestige 1, I'm like, okay, we're both trash. But no, now it's, like, Prestige 6 non-fucking-stop. It's chaotic, dude.
How about this guy? Oh, no, guys, I can't play any games. I gotta study for my midterm. A.K.A. been grinding out the levels.
Dude, you don't even know, like, I have something like 21 hours in For Honor. The game came out, you know, 10 weeks ago, right?
2100?
Shit, I have 2100 hours in For Honor. Zelda came out on Friday, and both Austin and Nick are like, oh yeah, I got 35 hours. We're recording this on Tuesday afternoon for reference sake. Everyone's like, wow, you must really like For Honor. You've been playing a lot of it. These fuckers put in like one Earth week of playtime into Zelda in 1.1 Earth weeks.
What do you consider an Earth
roasted
week?
For it. Like it's a week on planet Earth. You got this, Dan. I can smell it. Knock him into the geyser.
Are you alive?
Yeah, dude.
Get your ass over here.
I'm not gonna fight this dude, man.
Why?
He's just gonna build his revenge meter and then he's gonna go Bane from Batman and Robin on us.
Well, I could come just do a quick drive-by on him. See what he does. I'm serious. Just run by. See
I
what he
hate
does.
To do this, but like bring him over here and I'll hide behind this tombstone and then I'll knock him into the geyser.
This is the sole reason why we're playing this game right now, just so you know. Oh. No, I gotta execute on it. Okay, come here, big fella.
Oh, I'm getting out of the way. I don't want to impede your one versus one duel.
Are you close? You got a shot on him?
Yeah, I'm right there.
There, now's the moment. Why did you take?
He had precedent from another move. But I gotta be honest, even just doing that made me very uncomfortable.
But why? Instead, you'd rather see my blood standing over the enemies. Drill the kill.
Exactly. Jong Soo Jong. Isn't that the guy that voiced Duke Nukem?
I believe so. Did you ever play that game?
I played some of the Duke Nukems.
Did you play Duke Nukem 3D?
I did play Duke Nukem 3D.
Did you ever go to that one area where there was dancers and then...
That's like, you mean like the start of the game?
Yeah.
Yeah, no, I've been to the start of the game.
And then
I got my ass kicked.
Okay, now here's where I walk in the courtroom and look over and say, ladies and gentlemen of the jury, I present to you a case why we should 2v1 people.
No, you don't need the 2v1 if you can beat him 1v1. You don't have to worry about the revenge factor.
Okay, well, as evident in that last round, yeah, I know you're a man of fact.
Yeah, I mean... I don't know what that means, but sure.
Should we 2v1 next time?
No, you should never.
But he beat us.
Yeah, they beat us. So what, dude? That's life, dude. Sometimes you hit, sometimes you get hit. I know Daniel G is not familiar with what it means to lose, but.
Oh, I've done my share of losing, but I try to avoid losing at all costs. What? How you doing over there?
Oh, I'm getting my ass beat, dude. I am dead. This is one of those situations where you go, oh, level 3 Conqueror, no big deal. And then you realize this is actually his 8th For Honor account.
Okay, now I'm going to walk in this guy's general vicinity. And let's see if he comes after me.
Dude, I'm telling you, you're the only dude adding complications into this system. If you play online, it's like 2% people that actually fuck up the 1v1s.
See, well, you know what? I don't want to be part of the 98%. Did you just get a network connection?
We got kicked out. Are you in the game?
Yeah.
I'm not in the game.
It came back.
I got booted. Yeah, but I'm not in it.
Okay. So.
Are you going to slay him?
I'm dead.
All right. You might as well just bounce. Well, you know, nobody's gonna be mad about it, I think.
Okay.
Dude, yeah. We have to get like one. All I ask is one round win. That's it.
Okay. All I ask for then is if the win is in the balance and there's a 2v1 opportunity, can I implore you to maybe just dip your toe in the water?
Like, you're not listening, though. It doesn't give you an advantage much of the time. It just leads to you being murdered.
But. Okay, say we're at PAX East, okay?
And so we're not playing this video game in which all of the conditions of the discussion are relevant.
And say Rob starts or gets into a fight, okay?
Okay, all right. Seems highly plausible.
And it's Rob versus some guy that, you know, is maybe doing some work on Rob, okay? So maybe he takes a few shots to the dome piece, okay?
That also seems plausible.
So you have a chance to help your friend.
Right.
And put a few pieces on that guy's dome piece.
Did Rob start it?
Let's just say we're in an alternate universe where Rob didn't start it.
I mean, definitely I would like... I mean, there's no way that alcohol's not involved here.
Mm-hmm.
So I would be like, hey, bouncer, go get that dude off my friend. And then I would like call the police. And then I'd like try to pull him off.
Say you're in a desert island and it was just you three.
This is madness. What am I going to like bash the dude over the head with the freaking rock or something like that?
Well, there's a chance that he could put Rob out of commission and then it's going to be you versus him.
No.
You're not going to do it?
Hey, take a look at King Snipe's emblem.
What is it?
What do you think it is?
A spider?
It's absolutely a spider.
Are you referring to... Are you referring to those upper left and upper right things as ovaries?
Maybe. Or, you know, just a mustache.
All right, so you're not... So I can't even...
Well, I don't know. Here's the thing. I don't want to go, like... Oh, God, I'm fighting the dude with the loot emblem. You know he's got to be good if he's got that emblem.
Here's the thing, what?
Here's the thing. I don't want to go to an American hospital, dude. Like, I definitely don't want to go to American jail, but I, like, 100% do not want to go to an American hospital, you know?
Why?
You should. It's going to cost me, like, $200,000.
No, you get free insurance everywhere.
You don't get free insurance everywhere by being Canadian. The American doctors don't go, oh, he's Canadian.
But don't they cover you?
No, you gotta buy travel insurance, man.
What's up with that, Justin Trudeau? You may have a six-pack, but you're leaving my boy NL out to dry in the mean streets of Chicago.
In a different country. Oh.
So you're gonna leave Rob. At least Rob knows.
It depends on the situation.
It's he dies, and then you die, or the other guy dies.
Why am I dying?
Because he's gonna fight you next.
I don't understand why this guy's got such a problem with me.
He's
just like a serial killer or something?
Wait, you won the Tournament of Shame, right?
Yeah. Dude, I'm telling you. The game has passed us by. People are actually good now. And also, everybody in the comments is right, and I was just the least trashy out of all six of us.
What do you mean by trashy?
Like the least horrible. He's done it!
Okay, do you put any work on this individual?
He's probably like half dead.
Are you still alive?
I got executed in a big way.
What's your
cop? This is Wesley Snipes?
I think it's not Wesley, but it's his son, Charles.
Charles Snipes?
Yeah. Oh, he deked me.
Yeah, he's got some combos. Oh, he's done it.
Get back. Get back.
Okay. Yeah, he goes for that a lot.
I feel like this is important for us. So.
It's morale. It's morale. He's done it. He's done it.
He has done it! Let's go! Let's go.
The okay. Soderbergh twins win again.
Okay.
What? Look at it, like, so sportsmanlike, right? Somebody just beats you in a duel and you go, ah, I got unlucky. Good round, though. Like, you know, you're trash and I should have won, but, like, good round, though. Like, I had a really fun time.
We're lucky this game doesn't have VoIP. I would give it to him. I would. In a very respectful way. Like, I wouldn't swear or make derogatory comments, but...
Right, yeah.
Oh, that's Gabe calling. Hang on.
All right. What does that mean?
You still haven't listened to Pablo?
I thought for sure I saw Gabe Newell in downtown Vancouver on Sunday.
Did you stop him?
No. Caden and I were in a restaurant, and he, like... Well, I'm saying he, but there's no guarantee that it was actually him, I suppose, right? But, like, a dude that looked a lot like him walked by the window.
And what'd you do? Like,
well, I just went, I think that's Gabe Newell.
You know how you could tell for sure if it's him?
I don't know.
There was a...
Ask him?
No, there would have been a golden Lamborghini with 30-inch rims outside. And the license...
I think that if anybody's going to gank me, it's probably going to be Charles Snipes.
Oh, kick him!
We're both too good for this.
Oh, nice. Do you think...
Man, how did you beat this guy? Like, he's pretty good, man.
This game is 99% mental, 1% not mental.
Right, yeah. If only they'd make a word for that not mental part. Some pizza, pepperoni pizza.
Do you think Gabe Newell has a customized license plate? Nice kill.
Well, this guy has 100% of his HP. I think he doesn't want to fight on the bridge because, you know, he's worried I'm going to push him off. But I'm not about enabling that kind of laziness. You fight me over the bridge if you want to get the win here.
I'm going to...
Yeah, exactly. Just needle him. Start to undermine his confidence.
Wait, do you have a custom license plate?
No.
Do you think Gabe does?
Yeah, why not?
What do you think it would say?
Gaben. That seems like the obvious one, right?
I was going to think 3%.
Why 3%?
Because he gets 3% of every transaction on the planet Earth. So what is this guy doing?
Well, he's like, he doesn't want to fight me. Despite having an advantage in that he has 5 times my HP, he doesn't want to fight me out in the open. Because then he could get one thrown. And I mean, I understand the logic behind that. But also, I ain't about that lifestyle. He got me anyway.
I feel like he was trying to set you up to chuck.
No, he's just, I mean, I understand, right? It's like game theory. He's got 100% HP. I got like 20%. The only way I'm likely to beat him is if I just throw him off the edge cheaply. So, of course, I'm like, yeah, I'm going to try to throw this dude off the edge cheaply.
Why wouldn't you?
Exactly.
I feel like
he's got to meet me halfway. I'm not going to give up every advantage.
I feel like this is a rare game. In fact, like, there's a community that's... what's the word for someone that looks down on other people?
Snobby?
Yeah.
Yeah, there's a little bit of that, to be honest with you. Like, there are people who forget that, like, it's actually a fighting game and it's balanced. Like, the Warlord has great throws. So everyone's like, oh, you threw me off the edge. That's not fair. Yeah, well, I don't have an endless combo where I just go Mizulu, Mizulu over and over. Like, you gotta make up for it. I'm not suggesting the Warlord's underpowered, but you gotta make up for it in some other ways, you know?
It's not the size of the boat, it's the motion of the ocean, that sort of thing?
Precisely correct, or something.
Oh.
Dan, I think you might have rattled this dude.
Because I asked if he was 7?
Yeah, he said LOL what, and I think you got inside of his head.
Warp Throw Meg is inside my head right now. Are you going to win your fight?
Oh no, I think he's going to get me. He's got me.
What do you think right now?
Close though.
In the future, what do you think we're doing right now at PAX?
Wait, like at the time this video goes up?
This exact second.
What do you mean this exact second? Because like depending on when you're watching the video, it could be like many different times.
Well, let's just say when it goes live.
Okay. Well, what time do you want to make it live?
Probably sometime, say 1:30.
Okay. Why on the half hours? That's unusual.
Wow, this guy's going off.
Yeah, he's pissed because I almost got a kill last time.
So what are we doing right now in the future?
Well, I still don't. Okay, 1:30 Eastern time. And this one's probably going to go up on like Friday. We're probably grabbing lunch or something, right?
You think we're getting hamburgers? Or you think we're at a restaurant?
I mean, one in the same, buddy. One in the same.
Well, we could be having the Super Mario patties.
Yeah, we could pay $12 for like a Kraft Singles sandwich at the convention center. Oh, Jesus.
This guy's decked out. All the ornaments.
You never go for a taunt when your boy is on the case.
I believe it. I believe in you.
This is a bad time. What if I do this? Check this out, Dan. You want to see, like, scum techniques?
Oh! He's done it! He's done. You have to win now. You have to win.
He had me so cold. It was like I couldn't get a single hit on him.
You gotta win here. If you win, quite possibly the greatest comeback of all time.
He's just nonstop measles.
How do you stop a measles?
You dodge like out of the way. Are you going to take that from this dude? He said, all right, mate.
Well, I don't want to know how far. If I push too far, sometimes you get mad because it represents you. So I don't want to push too hard.
That is true. Oh! He got me. Good round, though. Good round.
What did he say last time? Good round, but.
Yeah, it's... unlucky GR. Yeah, exactly. I love... This is the fastball special where you just hit him in the face.
All right, so what did we played three or four games?
I don't know. We played like seven, and we lost them all. But, you know, that's life. That's life, man.
Being a game theorist, let's just say we've taken into consideration your strategy for approaching getting wins.
Yeah.
The next video, just for logic, I mean...
Our names are attached to this. These people will find us. This community doesn't joke around, man. I'm going to be ostracized from the town halls.
I think Northern Line with the zero will be, but you're a completely different individual.
You know, nobody that I play, like sometimes I get recognized, but they go, fake NL. And then I just fucking go wild on them. Because if they don't think it's really me, what reputation am I trying to protect, right? Just go ape shit on them.
Yeah.
Anyway.
So I'm just going to propose we do that for our next video.
Okay. Well, I'll tell you, we'll make a condition. If we win a 1v1, then come in on the 2v1. But don't kite your opponent over to the other guy.
Okay.
It just creates the disaster.
All right. Now we're talking my language. All right.
I'll meet you halfway.
Okay. That's negotiation right there.
Exactly. Dave, right. I learned it from Gaben when we got drinks at the Cactus Club this weekend.
Is that
3%?
You went to a place called the Cactus Club?
It's a restaurant chain in Vancouver that's like mid-scale.
Do they serve cacti?
They actually, you have to sit on a cactus. That's not true, though.
What did you eat there,
Daniel? Let's finish this episode.
Well,
man.
Just tell me what's like the average plate.
It's a pub or like a casual dining place.
Called the Cactus Club. That sounds anything but a casual place to me.
Well, that's because they want to charge you like an extra $6 per entree. So they throw that little Cactus Club on there. They dim the lights. Everyone's got a button-up shirt on. And all of a sudden, you're in, you know, $16 a sandwich territory.
Did you wear a button-up shirt?
Absolutely not.
Did you have a snapback on?
Absolutely.
Good for you.
Thank you.
Never change.
You think Bill Gates gets dressed up? I don't know. He probably does on occasion.
I don't know. But did you just compare yourself to Bill Gates?
I said Gil Bates.
Oh, okay.
He's the number 30 realtor in the city.
All right. Well, we will take Gil Bates, and we're going to take in the next episode, we're going to take a different approach.
We're going to win one round next time.
That's the goal.
Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, click the like button. Helps out a great deal. Of course, subscribe if you want to see more in the future. For now, check out Daniel's perspective. Check out my perspective. We'll see you next time.
See you guys.